legend of local powerboat racing says he actually began racing in the second edition of the race, which he actually won.
Well, my first involvement was the second year when we built my first Vista Solo, and that was back in 1970. And as I said, that was my first race, and I was very fortunate to come out on top, winning the race. And that was, I think, an hour and 28 minutes, if I remember correctly.
With a 50-year history, the legendary racer says he's not surprised by its longevity.
Yes, I did. The reason I said so is when Express on Akineni gave up the race, I called Brian Bowen. I said, "Brian, we cannot let this race die. Would you race with me? I put my trophy on the beach." He said yes. And then we started getting a committee together amongst my friends to form a committee to carry on the great race. So there's no surprise to me that the race is on for 50 years.
Competing in powerboats has not been without tragedy for Ken Charles, as he lost his sons, Sheldon and Curtis, in an accident. And it's in their memory he continues to race, along with his other son Hayden, who has also won the race on 5 occasions.
1985 was one of the best great races that I had, and that is with Sheldon and Curtis, and beating King Sailor by 2 seconds on the winning line. And after that, we came back, after the death of my boys, the family had a meeting and decided we would race in their memory, because we knew that they would like us to race again. Oh, it was elated to see Hayden behind the wheels, and I guess he'll be back there again in the near future.
Over the years, the legendary racer has had several crew members, but in 1999, one for the first time, with Darren Marshall on the throttles and Gino Fusco in navigation. The duo holds him in high regard.
Well, he is a legend on his own. It's an honor to be racing with him, and it's great to get his experiences, his experience throughout the years of racing, and we have a very good relationship, and it's an honor.
That's the greatest great race, is the race with Ken. When you win with Ken, it's the greatest experience in the world. Especially when you get to dance on deck. But he says he's going to dance on deck if he wins this year too, right?
But what does this great race mean to them?
The great race is the greatest thing in the whole year of racing. But this year should be called the great, great race. Because the 50th anniversary, and there's more participation. International competitors. And all some of the old folks coming back out again to have some good times.
They say their favorite memory was setting the course record, which now stands at 58 minutes.
That race, that year, they had a handicap start, and we knew that prior to the race, there was no way we would cross the line first. So we had a meeting secretly, unknown to Ken, that this was between Hayden, myself, and Gino, that we will race the clock. And that we did. And I think that achievement is the greatest achievement in the great race between in the solo team, actually. I remember getting to Tobago, and a while after, Ken was in the race, and he was with his son-in-law. He got into Tobago like about an hour after us, and he looked at me. I immediately told him, never again. And he told me, I was glad I wasn't in that boat.
But after 50 years in a dangerous sport, what would the legendary Mr. Charles like to see moving forward?
But the committee has been doing an excellent job. I must congratulate them, bringing it up to what it is today. The only thing that is lacking is aerial coverage. And if we could have gotten a helicopter to cover this race, it would make it more the better.
Kent Fuentes, C-Sport Extra.